Hello, this is Solar PVTV from the World Future Energy Summit 2017. And now we are together with Naji, our partner also. So first of all, Naji, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For the cooperation with Solar PVTV. And this is for our special coverage for Solar PVTV, but also for WFES2V. Naji, first of all, I have to tell you, because this is my fifth time, and it's the last hour of the show. And yes. Look at the expo floor. It's so busy. And it was so great. You are so tired, but you still have forces to speak with us. So Naji, how was it actually this week for you?
Well, it was an amazing one. This marks the 10th edition of the World Future Energy Summit that was incepted in 2008, together with the other four co-located exhibitions, the International Water Summit in strategic partnership with ADWEA, the fourth Eco-Waste in partnership with TEDWIR, the Solar Expo, and the Energy Efficiency Expo. Really, this week, Thomas, has been a tremendous one, has seen thousands and thousands of people, experts, policy makers, decision makers, coming together from over 170 countries to discuss the future of the industry, to discuss the latest developments, the future projects, and basically do partnerships and business. So it has been a tiring but tremendous week on all aspects.
Yeah, Naji, because you see, when I met you a few minutes ago, you were so tired, so exhausted, but now you are so excited. Yeah. Because when you see the success, yes. Everything is so great.
Exactly. Right? The success, yeah, you know, it's very rewarding for any organizer. And I'm happier when I hear the positive comments from the exhibitors, from the visitors who have been here, who have invested in time and money to be with us in this 10th edition and the co-located events with WFES. So it gives me a great pleasure and a great boost to put more thoughts into strategies, future strategies, to develop the events in a way that they cater to the needs of our partners.
But I think that it's even more important, you know, because when I was recently in Nigeria, the first publicity on the television was, if you would like to forecast the future, just build it, yes? And you are the guys who are building the future, yes?
Yeah, exactly. We try to set actionable solutions for all the policies that have been announced or made. So this is the strength of Abu Dhabi Sustainability. Abu Dhabi Sustainability Week that comprises all these events and more to find actionable solutions for the policies and regulations put by governments.
And can you tell me also, because we are on this impressive stand of Masdar and still so busy, and how is your cooperation with Masdar and how do you see the future cooperation?
Of course, Masdar are the host of the event since 2008. In partnership with Masdar, we organized the World Future Energy Summit. It has been a fruitful experience and a fruitful partnership between both organizations, Reed Exhibitions and Masdar.
And Naji, because you are speaking with a lot of companies, a lot of decision makers, and we spoke a few days ago with quite a lot of high-level people about 100 renewable energies achievable. And do you think it's possible, and how your exhibition, your activities would like to or will contribute to this goal?
I'll talk from an individual point of view, not necessarily from an expert point of view. I think, yes, it is achievable, because maybe one or two decades earlier from now, maybe the 20% was not achievable. The 30%, the 40% that was reached in the region, mainly in Morocco, 42%, and all the targets that have been put by governments, whether in UAE, Abu Dhabi, Dubai, or in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, all these targets, yes, are achievable. Whenever there is a will, there is a way to achieve it. So yeah, it is achievable. But the point is not now to reach the 100%. The point is to make a shift, a natural shift from traditional energy sources to renewable energy sources. And this is what is happening in the region here. It's a natural and studied shift towards renewable energy.
And you are one of the actors who is helping to make this shift as smooth and also as quick as possible, yes?
Yes, as the World Future Energy Summit, bringing all these experts together, yes, the event is a catalyst for the industry to grow and to accelerate in the region and beyond.
So we met first time in Paris, maybe in 2007, 2008, solar PVTV was so small. You were also running after the exhibitors because your event was so small, and now it's such a huge success. I would like to ask you a bit more futuristic question. How do you imagine World Future Energy Summit, the 20th edition?
We hope to double the size of the World Future Energy Summit in the next 10 years. Of course, this is all linked to the growth of the industry, which I'm very positive about.
Okay, thank you so much, and Solar PVTV will be helping you. And once again, thank you so much, Naji, for the cooperation.
Thank you, Thomas. Thank you.
And bon anniversaire.
Oh, merci.
Thank you so much. That was Solar PVTV with Naji, the director of this very successful event. And very tired, but very positive. Still hundreds of people, even we are 5 minutes just before closing the fair. Yep. Thanks for watching.